It's gonna be tough. I'm not gonna even lie here. It's gonna be tough. That Alchemist will be split farming. I like they pick up like that they picked up a Razor,
Ten
self-sustaining
seconds
hero in the
remaining.
lane, being able to, you know, you could run a core Alchemist and let
Five
that Razor go
seconds
mid as well.
remaining.
But if they're going safe lane Razor, it could be because they want to leave that Razor alone and just really
Reserve
gank the hell
time.
out of that middle lane, gank the hell out of another lane. Maybe even attempt an
10 seconds
aggressive tri lane or something
remaining.
else, because Razor's a self-sustaining carry. Can fend for himself
Five
pretty
seconds
well in the
remaining.
middle, and ooh, slot a pickup
Dire
here.
team pick.
Well, this is concerning. They are running a heavily physical lineup against a Winter Wyvern and even a Tusker. It's gonna cause some troubles for them with that snowball, with that sigil. I say that sigil is gonna be extremely tough for Slaughter to navigate through. Razor is another troublesome one. You can't exactly amplify him to great effect, as that purge will cause you a lot of mobility problems, especially since it
10
got buffed a
seconds
couple of versions
remaining.
back. But this is a strat that's been run more commonly nowadays. You have that
5 seconds remaining.
lineup where you just turn everyone to mush and just shoot them down with your plinks and cut them up with
Reserve
your
time.
fishman slaughter. But I still have a lot of reservations to this because there is that Winter Wyvern, so it's kind of weird that they will pick a physical lineup into this. But well, we'll see what happens here. We still have one more pick from Trust. It will be a off lane, I assume. It could be off lane Tusk already, and they want to just pick up another hero. Say maybe an Earthshaker wouldn't be too bad here to stop the aggression. It would land them in a double melee, well, a lot of melee, triple melee lineup. But I think it shouldn't be too much of a problem. The Earthshaker will be great here. Something unorthodox could be a Zeus as well to check out the Bounty Hunter Kling's whereabouts. Nuke down a Slaughter because he's water type. But yeah, jokes aside, it is because of his sprint, making him take extra damage. It also could be something like, I don't know. Okay, Lich. Yeah. That's what they like to do. They like to pick a Lich to buff up their heroes that actually lack the armor. In this case, not so much, but Alchemist is one of them. He's really good on the health department, but if he needs something, it will be a armor buff. So he always has to, if a carry Alchemist wants to get into the fight, he always needs that Assault Cuirass or something along those lines, a mechanism or whatever, just to beef up his armor, to let him make use of that huge HP pool as well as regeneration. So we're gonna hop into the game very quickly here, and we're gonna run through the lineups. We'll do more Tieri crafting later on. We got some disconnects going on. It always happens here in Southeast Asia. But yeah, this Lich is kind of like a, I wouldn't say a signature, but it is kind of a thing out of Trust. And just for note this here, you guys just join us in the chat, it is a 2-minute delay stream, so any of those technical problems, I will be able to deal with immediately once I see them in chat. But there will be a little bit of response time, so please be nice, guys. Don't pile on me for little minor errors. I think I've got the overlay checked. I'm just gonna do that one more time. Yes, I have got that overlay checked. If you're wondering who I am Lysander, and I'm gonna be giving you a broadcast for today, and hopefully it will be a good one. So yeah, let's put my name on the top right corner, and you guys will won't have to ask as much anymore. Here we go. Just gonna put it up there, and since we have a pause, we got a little bit of time. And yep, there we go. All right, there we go. Top right corner, and we're gonna have that game begin proper. So let's run through the teams. We have Lakels running that Golden Razor helmet. I love it. It's one of my favorites. I think it's a great mix here, golden and blue, very Protoss-ish. And that Razor is going to be on Lakels. Jabs, it will be playing that Winter Wyvern. My pro, that middle lane player, will be playing the Alchemist Fei Mao. Also, Fat Cat in Chinese. We're playing Lich Abba on this Tusker. And I love this Lich play because of that Lich change, you can just effectively steal experience from an enemy tri lane, and it just really punishes them so much for running. And it kind of forces them to either adapt, change their lanes, or just suffer the XP loss. And it's really huge because it slows down the tempo and it spits perfectly into an Alchemist draft. You want to have that Alchemist sit on a little bit of time, get that farm up, and you don't want the enemy to pile on the aggression early. And that's exactly what a Bounty Hunter, what a Slaughter, and even to some extent a Kling aims to do, with a little bit of security on the side Dazzle. So alright, let's talk through the Malaysian squad here with Minerva playing the Dazzle, I mean. We've got Slaughter played by Yamate himself, Ben on the Klings. We have Doombringer played by Ice, and we have 3-4-3. I'm gonna play that Bounty Hunter. So I would say I favor the Trust lineup just because of this bloody hero. It's physical heavy, but I would say especially with that Lich lineup now. Alright, we're gonna fight here. Ice could be in trouble here. Shackle, there's the shot. Gonna block him off. I'm surprised he's running this way. Gonna give his fans more openings. Bounty Hunter is gonna get slowed down, but Ice gonna get slowed so much. Oh, good heal will keep him alive there. So a little bit of tasers here from Kells. Just gonna do extra damage, and we're already forcing out a salve here for Minerva. So it looks like it will be a middle lane slot. Wow. Alright, middle lane Slaughter here from Yamate. He will have Minerva by his side. I'm not sure if it is going to be the case. Are they going to sit by there? This Bounty Hunter should not be able to get any snipes if they were paying any attention. But my pro already up at 600 bucks. I believe it was the Bounty Rune secure there. Very funny miss there on that last hit. We'll see if he gets this one. Yes, he does. So he already purchases his portal. And he's going to start running in now. Are we going in for the Windwalk? No, we're not. Jabs is going to be notified right away. Good Op of Venom start. We'll do some heavy damage here to the Winter Wyvern with that slow move speed. Not going to be able to move fast away before taking a few swipes to the behind. But other than that, we have Trust running a 2-1-2 lineup. It's very signature of them, like I said. Well, not really 2-1-2, but rather 1-2-2. He will get that sentry ward denied in the middle. Lakels will be fending for himself top lane. He will do pretty well against Doom, although the Doom should be getting a pretty comfortable start himself because of that lack of kill power. For now, he's just going to enjoy the EXP gain, and having gone for Scorched Earth first is going to limit his power just a fair bit. Ever taking a huge heal bomb there, going to lose about a fifth of his health. So I like this Lich and Tusker lineup. It forces them into a dual lane situation. Like I said, it will punish that EXP loss. So you have their Bounty Hunter already sitting by the side there. Oh, Yamate going in for that crush to defend himself. But there is no stun here. Yamate, like I said, as a melee hero, it's going to be extremely difficult to play this Slaughter role against this Alchemist. It's going to be so punishing. You can't dive because they're minus armor. You take that constant ticking with that acid spray doing 20 damage a second, and that minus 5 armor reduction, and being it physical damage is really concerning as well. So it looks like Dazzle is going to try and take a run down bottom. He's going to get caught out. Oh no, Grave as well. Went for touch level 1. If only they knew. He's still not graving, and then Ball comes in. That's Buzz Blood. Abba will take that one easy. Kill in the offlane. Dazzle, very poor positioning here. Running in for that rune in such a poor angle, especially in a 2v2 lineup. His Kling cannot do anything to help him out. So poor positioning will cost them first blood here. The Thailand boys take the first kill off this game. So 3-4-3 coming in with that swipe once again. Still only sitting at that level 1. The Wyvern coming in again. Gonna slow Yamate. Yamate will immediately take a run away. And the Crush here slowing down the Alchemist, so he will not be able to chase. But again, he doesn't have unstable concoction, so he doesn't really give a damn. 3-4-3, only level 1, will not be able to do much here in this lane. Ice finally hitting that level 3 mark. Like I said, this Doom will have to make some big plays, make some big rotations. I do believe he can go for Midas and probably should. I might be misinforming him here, but we'll see. He's got the slow attacks here, but there's no way in hell he's going to be able to kill a Razor without Doom. So that time is still far, far off. He's only got a Clarity Potion left in terms of supplies, so doesn't want to be too aggressive here. We'll draw that range creep to the side there, and 3-4-3 will immediately back off. And gets 9 gold just for dewarding that ward, so good stuff here. My pro turning everything into money. But thus far, I'm not liking this... I am not liking this mid Slaughter, I can tell you that much. It does give him the levels he needs. Going for bottle also slows down his item progression. He doesn't really need it, he isn't using the bottle. Yeah, as you can see, he's wasting a lot of bottle charge, especially with that bottle nerf to HP. He's just wasting that bottle, I feel. He doesn't really need that mana spam. Crush is really cheap. All of his other spells don't require mana. And bottle just seems like it's for rune control, and it doesn't really do much for him, so he's gonna run in there. Gives a smack to my pro, but he's gonna secure that rune. So I guess apart from securing runes, he doesn't really have that much to in the way of bottle usage. Crush costs so little, you don't really need the bottle. But I could be wrong here. They're about to go gank in here on them. Yamate coming in, but he's gonna get caught out. There's a snowball rolling in. There's a lot of minus armor as well. The shots will land, and Slaughter taking the aggressive there will actually get himself killed and sick play on that Cold Embrace. And meanwhile, Bounty Hunter trying to go in for that Razor that caught by a offline Sentry Ward. And getting punished there, but Lakel's already having the power threats and free ranks in Plasma Field will grab him out. So like I said, 1-2-3 always, I mean, they have good experienced players, they have known players in the scene, they've been around for quite a while, but they don't seem to be playing in that coherence you see out of pro teams, and it just really seems to be punishing them. I feel like it's not doing them as much good as it should. I mean, they have a strong lineup, but they just don't seem to be playing like a well-oiled machine a pro team should be. So, but yeah, I'm hoping to see some good plays out of them right now. Maybe it's just a little bit of a slow start. It is a BO3 after all. They still have that second game to come back on if they screw up this one. But of course, you always want to make their first time as good as possible. So we're going to take a look here at those last hits. 23 last hits here so far for Lakels on his Razor. One of the more talented carries, even more prominent carries here in Southeast Asia. Being able to carry the hell out of a lot of things. And so far, his team has been doing really well. He's got a good support crew as well. Behind every big carry lies some great care support. So, yeah, like you see, this Alchemist just gonna take some damage here. Alchemist having that low armor early will take quite a hefty amount of damage from a Slytherine Crush. But we'll have to see how the lanes go. But for now, it is still a pretty crappy lane here for 1-2-3. They have got some decent farm on the Klings. He's got 23 last hits, about to match up with Lakels, but because of the Klings poor animation, doesn't have as much denies. And if I look at the XP grub, I should see a huge dab. Yeah, there you go. 2000 in favor of Trust because of that Lich denial. It's always going to be extra painful. 2500 gold change as well. 343. Now going to be running back in, looking for that Razor. I don't believe they'll be able to kill him again. It is level 3 Scorched Earth now, so there is quite a bit of killing potential here on this Doombringer. It's extremely potent, especially at that level 4. That 48 heal is pretty brutal. Now Yamate coming in with that amplified damage, a minus 10 now on this Alchemist. Gonna take quite a chunk here, but I don't think he'll be able to do much yet. My pro is just gonna fight him out, and yeah, he's just gonna back off. Just taking a little bit of ticks down here with that Winter's Curse, or rather the Arctic Burn. And well, not gonna be too concerned for now. Alchemist just gonna run to the jungle and look for a stack. He has that Chemical Rage, so he doesn't really care about taking damage. He's gonna pop his ultimate now, and he's gonna go in there, and yeah, we're gonna Splinter Blast this up, and we're gonna farm, share some EXP with that Bounty Hunter. Bounty Hunter coming in here, not sure if they saw him, is the question. And 343, he's gonna come steal some. Yep, there's now level 3, stealing that much-needed EXP, but meanwhile, Razor gonna be whipping that Doom into shape. He's forced to use that Scorched Earth, got that on cooldown for now, and will not be able to dodge out as much of those fights now. Yamate coming in for my pro on that gank. Will they be able to get that kill though? Coming in, amplifies him up, but will not be getting any kind of kill. I'm surprised. Oh, turns it purple. Alright. It's an interesting color tint there. Usually it just dampens them, but I guess this makes him purple. I just water from Slaughter just interacting with all those chemicals that my pro has been abusing. Dirty drug addict. Oh, just gonna go for a casual punch of Ben. No real aggression other than that, but a nice little punch of that. We'll trap in that Dazzles off at 210 damage. A lot of, you can almost see it. This Abba Tuska just itching for a fight. Oh, that's a glow yarn. It's really nice. Let me take a look at this. Yeah, it's glow yarn. This infused cannon puncher, the barrier rogue. It's actually really nice. But no special animations though, which is kind of a shame. It has nice particle effects, but no special animation. But still, pretty cool so far. Throws out more shots, even lands in the dazzle, perfectly lined up there. Abba puts that pretty well. My pro getting amped up once again. Yamate has that regeneration rune of 1400 gold, so it's rushing that blink dagger. 8 minutes in, still doesn't have it, but Minerva, look at him. Getting trapped up once again. How's Feimao doing? Feimao, he's got that Chain Frost ready again. And well, Dazzle forced the TP out home, so they know that this guy is alone. And they could be ganking him. Do they have dust on board? They do not. They do actually. They do have dust. Will they dust it up? Yeah, they're gonna shot him in. They know. And the dust will tag him. And now he's there. Ben in a lot of trouble. He pops that strafe though. He gets punched into the sky. He's gonna get picked off. And are they gonna get Cold Embrace? Cold Embrace has a long range. And it will save him. that level 1 level dev gonna be doing bonus because of that level 6 on Lich. So poor the guy is gonna take a fall there, gonna doom him up. Nice shots here from Abba, will keep his buddy alive, and it's ready to duel out Ice. Gonna snowball into him and maybe even punch him into the sky. Again, Ice gonna be between a rock and a hard place. Gonna get punched up, he's gonna be slowed as well. They might go back in, but there's a dazzle in the sideline, so they don't want to take any risk here. And they'll back off safely. So no losses there, apart from the Lich. Well, they get a Lich loss because of that level death nuke burst. But now the Chain Frost comes in. It will bounce to the side. It will get those creeps farmed up. So stealing far from his carry, but no problem at all. The Fat Cat will secure a kill on Yamate Slaughter. Once again, trying to kill the Immortal here. This is not happening. Slaughter is not solo killing a Alchemist with ulti ready because that regeneration is bonkers. Look at that 50 health regen. How are you gonna even regen? Well, out hit that. You will do extra damage to the Slytherin Crush, but your follow up punches just can't do enough. And this Alchemist, he's laughing all the way to the bank, and he's got 4 points in Grievous Greed now, about to get that Radiance. I really do not like how this is gonna affect pup meta, but so far, it's not looking good here for 1-3-3. Look at that net worth. We have top 3 all coming from that Thailand squad. Already up at 4,000 gold lead. You can account some of that to Alchemist, but really, look at Lakels, man. He's just free farming all day, even getting a bonus kill on that Careless Bounty Hunter early on in the game. So 3-4-3. He's only got the boots and the Obo Venom. Nothing really else to boast about. 2 points in Shuriken Toss and no opportunities at track. So really getting punished for his Bounty Hunter pick. Like I said, Bounty Hunter is not something you... Punished! And, Lakels happens to... Well, his Abba just happens to walk into the Bounty Hunter in the woods there. And, assaults him, so he's going down and he's not coming back up for a few more seconds, but he's been going down quite a fair bit. This Bounty Hunter already 0-2 in this game. Mypro is still gonna farm Mud Golems, the only hero that really likes farming Mud Golems a heck lot. Look at that, so much gold. Every little one gives him 30 gold. Already got that relic and almost at a Radiance. 11 minutes, well, 12 minutes in, free farming Alchemist will secure himself a Radiance. This is a new level of pups. They're gonna go for a smoke, a desperate attempt as well. They need to get that Doom Strike on this. They should be able to kill the Alchemist if they find him. And if he farms his wave before they get here, it could be bad. But oh, they pops ultimate. He pops the ultimate. Now they go for the Doom on him. Will they be able to get him in time though? Yeah, they will. Should be able to get this kill. Good crush, big damage as well. The level death will secure that. The out regen not gonna play into effect here. And that's a Blink Dagger for Yamate. So good kill. And the Malaysians will put one back on the board. 900 gold because of that huge net worth on Alchemist. You will get back a lot of gold their way. So big gold gain, and Jabs only has that boost of speed. We'll be going for arcane boots for now, I assume. But Bounty Hunter desperately trying to get that level 6 on the board. Devouring siege wagons, my new favorite thing as Doombringer. I think Doom is just so fun now. But so far, Ben, 0-2-2, not exactly the stellar start you expect out of your Klinks, but then again, Klinks is not exactly the best of heroes, especially when he's ganged up upon. But he has got a Soul Ring and a Tread, so he's got some basic necessities down pat. And now we'll see how well this gang works, especially with your Winter Wyvern by the side. That Cold Embrace is just 4 seconds of physical immunity, so you're not getting any kills whatsoever. They're gonna sprint on in, they're gonna look for Mypro, but come on, there's a Winter Wyvern there with Winter's Curse. You don't really want to go into that ice. Gonna get caught out here. Do they deploy the Chain Frost for this? No, they're not. He does have Alpha Wolf ready. He doesn't have any kind of armor though, so with proper slows, they could punish him, but Scorched Earth rank 4 is just insane. It's almost the same level as a ultimate from Alchemist at level 1. So that out regen is just ridiculous, especially since it dishes out that amount of degen to the enemies as well. It's a huge Radiance burn. And now Yamate is going to get slowed down by this ghost. Very pesky woman. We'll secure some of that. And a double damage here from Tuskar will kind of make them second tink. Well, have second thoughts before going in. And will he devour a new creep here? Will he stick to the Alpha Wolf? We'll see. And looks like he'll eat the small guy. So Jeffrey, the baby centaur, will get picked off. But so far, the Conqueror himself will be bait enough. Oh, we're going in. Plasma Field will tag him. No kills so far. Alright, so just a little bit of harassment. It's a level 9 Doombringer now. That big Alchemist kill really buffed him up a lot. And look at this thieving bastard. Going for the Shuriken Toss that steals the potato from stores and jabs. Oh, Slaughter and Tusker Spree on that bottom lane. But now we're gonna look at this Winter Wyvern. Does he have dust? He does not. And a good kill here. They did not use the Wii for this. Only Yamate's amplified damage and blink was required plus strafe. So very good kill coming out from that 1-3-3 lineup. So far, not bad getting some back on the board, but Alchemist is still left pretty much unchecked. That one dev is going to do pretty much nothing as the Radiance has already been used. So it really is going to be a challenge for them to be able to get anything done as the Alchemist starts farming at an obscenely fast rate. The Mantis Star should be next, I believe. Just plays the Naga. It could be Boots of Travel first, but yeah, deploying Acid Spray on a block camp. A little small boo-boo there from my pro, but Abba, so far, what's it up at? Nope. Yeah, got some dust, got some arcane boots. So looking to roll in on Klings, but Klings is already on that roam there. Oh, the slows come in and the saps as well. Are we gonna turn around for a Doom is the question? Good crush! We'll land that. Lakel's gonna have that plasma field deployed there. Yamate's gonna lose his life, but another surviving at 10 health. That brunch saving his life. And yeah, now the crush comes in as well. Lakel's will feed his life, but Winter's Curse, they will actually start pounding on their slaughter. It's okay, the Splinter Blast will do enough damage. So they trade 2 for 1 there. Good trade in favor of 1-2-3. They see they gain 1,200 gold, and this is some life coming back to the Malaysian squad. I had my doubts with them, but so far, this minus armor lineup is doing, well, I would say wonders, but it's doing averagely well. Oh, okay, no, Ben, that's not how you survive a gank. Slowing yourself down with Skeleton Walk is not exactly the best idea as well, but Nighttime Vision will build him out this time by Ben. Hitting that panic button, I guess it will still buff him up because the slow from dust is not as much. So, my bad, but still, my pro. Will get up all that gold in the jungle and will continue his bottle spree. Will he get another bounty rune is the question. He will get huge amounts from that as well, like 500 a pop. So it's very easy to earn money as an alchemist. You just print money pretty much. And 6 and 8, 16 minutes in now. We're looking at a bottom tier, tier 1 push. Ben, double damage here from Alchemist. Is he going for... okay, no. No, nothing to do with that, but Ben will steal some damage. He has 42 now because of that rank 4. It is a very constant spray as well. He only has 1 point unstable current, so it's not going to be as easy for him to get the survival there. But Lakel, he's probably baiting this. There is ice armor to alleviate some of that. Oh, there's going to be a shots on in. And we have amplified damage from Yamate. Yamate reveals his position. He's getting tagged by Acid Spray. Is he going to be able to run away in time, though? But yeah, he will be able to. And they will actually secure that kill on that sigil. So that's a lot of hindrance leveled here. But 3-2-3-4-3 running in there. Very greedy. Trying to get extra tags with that track. He will not actually get that. And now the tags come in onto Ben. The Link will be here. And Lakel steals 84 total damage. The Plasma Field will tag him at the end as well, doing an extra 300. To him, and this tier one tower should almost be certain to fall here. And they will start tagging it, but they're going in. Are they going in for the Doom? There is still a lot of minus armor here onto Razor, minus 12 to be exact, 13 now. But that will chase them away enough for Ice to get a denial here. Going for Academ Scepter first. All right, interesting choice. He had Midas already, and I suppose those big kills early on did help him work towards that early Academ Scepter, but still. A good play here so far from Signature. They're getting that Bounty Hunter kill and not overextending, being too greedy. Could have a repeat of what happened top lane, so not wanting to pursue that. And well, we'll get a denial as a result. But hey, small change in comparison to what this Alchemist has been printing. All that money he has been printing, pretty much exceeding the rest of the enemies. If you look there, 9,600. I mean, Doom farms fast, but this is just ridiculous. And oh, I love this. This is so good. Look at this. A minus 14 armor, the Strafe, the Medallion. Roshan is just gonna melt really, really fast. Some boss monster this guy is. Pathetic. 18 minutes in, they will get that Aegis. And looks like Lakel wants to have something to say about this. I'm not sure it's the right plan. They will break that bounty rune. Interesting. So, gets a little bit of a spike hit there. They have Bounty Hunter in the back lines. And so far, it's not too big a deal. A good illusion rune there is going to secure Alchemist even more farm. Now building to that Mantis style. So yep, it's the standard stuff that I've been seeing in my pubs. Alchemist first pick. And proceeds to Radiance, Mantis style, Octarine. And get countered by a... we found him. Dust up. Okay, the Sentry Wards will tag him. Will they have dust though? They have no dust. They waste so much. Is there a tier 2 tower? There is a tier 2 tower. And if they play this right... I wish Valve would give us sentry vision for towers so that casters can, you know, see how much the vision is. I mean, I could maybe remember the range, but sometimes, you know, you just need this around towers. So I really wish they would implement that. It's a small change. I wouldn't say it's too difficult a request, but still, Truster are doing pretty well here. I mean, considering the farm, they spot out Mypro, will tag him out. That's very dangerous. If someone had a dust there, he could have been blown the heck out of the water, but nope. We'll be getting away with that greedy play. Lakels pick up a Sanji and Yasha, an item I have started to grow into love. Its speed bonuses are just insane. And in one of those rare games where BKB is really not a necessity, I think Sanji and Yasha first is an absolutely okay item to have on your core because of the stats it gives. The movement speed bonus is huge and the tankiness as well. But so far, 4,000 gold in favor. Still, the XP is starting to hit back to zero mark because Alchemist, he might print money, but he will not print EXP. And a lot of the trust heroes are sitting back now. They're not really advancing, not upgrading themselves, not going into college. And as a result, we'll stay level 8s for quite a while now. Level 10 on Tuska, though. So, looking for that level 2 punch. Looks to be going for a 4 staff? I don't know. I'm gonna ignore this brunch because I don't think it's gonna be a. It might be a mech, actually. It might be a mech. Surprised the Lich isn't getting that, though. And also, they have something to say about this tier 1 push. Lich, Razor is tracked. And what a time to pause. I think he sees this. He sees this. It's like, I'm out. Does he have Scorched Earth? Yes, he does. He should be running away just fine. No problem at all. Minerva and Yamate are lying in the back, so do they want to pursue this? He has an Aegis though, I think going in might be a good choice. They will be able to blow up this Razor before he gets anything done. And Winter Wyvern, he has a Cold Embrace though, so maybe he can keep Lakels alive, so it might be a dangerous venture to go in on this Razor, but I have a feeling they might jump in. They're contemplating now, you know, they're thinking, alright, we got uplink, we got the dazzle backup, we got the weave. We can't exactly see who's coming in. Yeah, we can't see who's coming in. It looks like Lakels is all alone. We're gonna try and kill him off, but alright, they're going in. Nah, they're not. This is what I like to call feline plays. Oh, Abba. Gonna blink away, so we'll. No, nope, no harm, no foul. We're just gonna have more farming here from Mypro, just, you know, juicing up those creep waves. Already 1,700. And, Yamate scouts him out immediately. Throws out a stun. Good stun here from Mypro. The Radiant's Burn will keep him on his tail, but the Crush should be able to land. Oh, loses his ultimate. This is bad times, but oh, Radiant's Burn, man. Radiant's Burn. Essence spray to ground. Yeah, Mypro just walks out of there. Oh, wow, going in. Okay. And he gets that blink, that good blink there from Yamate, dodging that plasma field as well. And what a timing to get that plasma field by Yamate. Oh my gosh, he's gonna get punished so hard. But oh, get the punch there. Up to 3-4-3, they're going in. 1-on-1, Bounty Hunter versus Tuska. Bounty Hunter will lose, just not gonna check that anymore. But oh, Razor, gonna get punished for his. Oh no, never mind. 3-4-3 getting out of there. They even doom him as well. Yamate with a fast forward with that crush will secure some kills. Fameout is tracked up now, so a lot of gold could be potentially coming in. Abba getting earned up. The Shuriken Toss will come as well. Good bounces there. Will land on Fameout, land on Jabs as well. Good timing on that. And he doesn't have enough time for that Cold Embrace. Will nuke one. He has a Chain Frost right off cooldown now, but the track is there. And looks like Yamate wants blood. 5 seconds to that Blink Dagger. He wants it. And all that tag. Yamate. Okay, call down the Blink forward. And Yamate will get another one. Good Blink. It's a full team wipe. 11-9. And suddenly 1-3-3. They flip the tables on the Thailand team. And well, at the back of some amazing slaughter plays, he will secure himself quite a fair bit of track kills. Let's look at that goal. Oh, it's Desolator completed there. It's a Yamate Floods. I would say I agree with this. It helps with the diving, gives you more tankiness, and that lifesteal. Very much appreciated, I'm sure, from Klinks, who will be dishing out a lot of damage. Gives your teams insane. And overall, I think it's an excellent item this game. And he's running more of a supporting, or not supporting Slaughter, but more of an initiating Slaughter. Just really wants to beef up for his team. And well, Trust, they are looking shaky. I would expect them to take this game cruising, but they have picked a greedy lineup, so you wouldn't expect them to really show much fruits in this early stage for now. But 3-4-3. Oh, there are a lot of people here waiting to tag this guy down. But Yamate, oh, there's a Desolator as well. So much damage. Easy kill on Abba, and this tower should not be lasting too long as well. But Abba, gonna drop that frost armor on this tower, tank it up a little bit. But still, it's gonna be quite scary here. Oh, I didn't. Oh, okay. adds less for buildings, I think. Does it add less? No, okay, it doesn't. I keep mistaking it for the Ogre Armor, and now my pro getting called out. It gets a first hit bash as well, double damage on Yamate. Easy kill, Ice! We'll get that one as well, the Aghanim Scepter. This is the hard counter to Alchemist, I feel. This just really punishes an Alchemist. Unable to do much with all that farm. Just doom him, lock him down. I mean, all that money is for nothing. You just kite him up for that. He doesn't have any mobility. He doesn't have any kind of... Yeah, I think mobility is the main problem with Alchemist. You know, it's the same thing with Wraith King as well. But at least Wraith King has a spammable stun and reliable one. Not like this one, where it's a very average stun. And doesn't have the reincarnations kind of slow that Wraith King has, so I would say Wraith King is even better at dealing with kiting, and that's one of his biggest weaknesses. So we'll see. Dire's top tower has fallen. So far, Syktra's looking very shaky, but still, Abba is sitting very high up on that net worth chart, so we might see some kind of comeback in the future. But of course, getting caught out like this non-stop is, of course, not the plan. But hopefully this Alchemist loss will show Pups that he's not a good hero and stop using him, because I do not want to see farming Alchemists taking over the role as Naga and my Pup games. Just saying. Oh, more kills here. Lich getting picked off there, but so far, Syktra's, they're just running in. Not sure what they're doing. Getting crushed on Lucals. Lucals getting strafed down. Easy pickings there. There's really nothing much you can do. They got to punch Yamate. They will get that, but that's all they can get. They will get nothing else out of that. They will get 4 for only a Yamate kill. And this is steadily going downhill there for them. Look at that team fight recap. 2004 going their way. And now you see that gold graph going 5,000 in the way of 1-2-3. This game has officially turned over. And is MyPro going to go Octarine Core? Because I hope he does not. He really needs to help out his team in the fights. 7 armor isn't enough, my friend. You need to get some fighting items and go help out your team. So we'll see if that's going to be the case for him. So far, he's the only guy left alive. It will be a mechanism here from Tusker. I believe he needs the armor. But bottom tower is under I feel like he should be helping out more with maybe a solar crest or something like that. But not going to be the case here. I'd like to see what this Wyvern is getting. Probably a Blink Dagger to get some better initiations, be able to stay further back in the fights. So far, they're just getting punished heavily by this physical lineup. And this Doombringer, I feel, is going to be pivotal in this late game. You know, it's good security against the Alchemist late game. And well, my pro can't just be that one trick pony. It's gonna be a lot of carries for him to deal with in the late game, and my pro is not gonna be able to deal with this Doom. I feel like banning Doom is a mandatory when you're trying to run an Alchemist lineup, because he eats all that farm on the map. You really need easy reward. We'll see if this times out. There's 15 seconds left on it, so maybe not. Ben? So far, the Desolator. I love it when Kling says Desolator. He looks like a stormtrooper of his plasma rifles. And we could be seeing a quick kill here on this Alchemist. Oh, no, kind of Invis Rune. Oh, gets the Invis Rune, steals it, Ben. Immediately, Syktra's will ping it out, and they realize there's something there. And oh, this Observer just timing out. They immediately know that there's an Observer there. 343, now with the gem, we'll scout things out. It looks like Winter Wyvern will invest in a gem. Not sure how I feel about this. I mean, yeah, you check out Klings and Bounty Hunter, but I feel like your main problems are your sustains in the fight, so we'll see. Alright. So it is gonna be Octarine Core. Oh boy.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Still waiting for that
Radiant's bottom tower.
Gonna
is
be strafing
attack.
Down his tower. The glyph will be Dire's used there, and tower doesn't stand for long. One more shot will take him out. Ben.
Dire's top tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom
Black King
tower
has been activated. Has been bought here, so it's gonna be difficult that next fight. Not gonna lie here. What is he actually BKBing from though? I don't know why you would buy a BKB. Why would you buy a BKB?
Dire's top
All these things go through
attack.
BKB.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Now, alright, goes to that Invis, so for now, nothing's happening. My pro's gonna get that Octarine soon, so I guess. Wow, Lakel's not able to TP away in time. Didn't even try. There was a Blink Dagger on Doom, so I guess not. So, but yeah, he didn't even get it. It was Lakel's just coming in with that Blink Crush, I think. Being able to get that kill. So, getting Lakel's there on the tail end. Very big kill as the Roshan will be coming up very shortly. Oh, Abba! Time to run away. He will blink to the side, and he will survive to fight another day. But this ancient stack might not, as Yamate goes in for some larceny. Going in for that steal. A lot of gold coming his way as Yamate. Oh well, not gonna risk it. Yeah. Picks up a bounty rune. We'll bottle it up. And Roshan respawns there. And they know about it. Oh, okay. Trust knows about it. And looks like 1, 2, 3 are still left unaware. They still feel that this, you know, Roshan is not gonna be up just yet. The Radiance Burn from the Alchemist is gonna be annoying. He's got Haste Rune now. He's got that Mantis style. And he's got 4,000 gold. So you gotta buy it straight up. Fire Soul Booster. And he almost has it. He almost has it. The Octarine Core is gonna make things unbearable because it's gonna be quick cooldowns for a lot of things, especially that Chemical Rage, especially that Mantis style, that Boots of Travel. It's just gonna be red galore. So this game could be quite a while, which is why I do not advocate the Rise of Alchemist. I would rather have my Lashrak leaners back in. Oh, Ember, what the hell, dude? Oh man, going right in onto Ben. Ben pops that BKB, will dodge that plasma field, but Ice getting caught out in the grave though. Will it whip him in time? One more hit. Oh, he gets the Doom off. That is a shame because that's going to do a ton of damage here to that Razor. He probably will tick down because of the lack of heals. But I think he needs to go for medical assistance, my friend. You can't outrun Doom. You're going to die from this. Oh no, could have gone to the Wyvern there. Oh, Lakels. Failing math is gonna cost his own life, and well, if he had gone in for the cold embrace, he would have survived. But no, decides to rough it out. I'll walk off this disease, my friend. I'll be fine, he says. But oh, getting that stealth ninja kill there on this Roshan will be huge. Will they get it? They will. The shots come in. Oh, the blink could come in as well. The Wyvern going in. Are they gonna get it? Oh, they go for the blink. Oh, they try to go for the punch on Roshan. Doesn't get it. And now the Shuriken Toss is gonna tag up to the Jabs. And the Snowball going in, buying a little bit of time. But oh, Cold Embrace will secure all kinds of damage now. The shots will go in. The Aegis has been picked up. I'm not so sure about this fight, but Ben gets hit by a full duration. Sun is their grave. There is a grave. They're trying to bait everyone. Run away. 3-4-3. The Splinter Blast will land. Goodbye, Bounty Hunter. And no, the stuns here, Mypro. Still getting a lot of that Octarine. Gotta throw that stun onto Yamate. And the Radiance Burn is really limiting that fight. And Ben, please, don't die. The Radiance will be super embarrassing. And this Alchemist has become really, really farmed up because of that Octarine Core, that healing. He's become that mega tank. So, well, unable to get the Amplify on him, I believe. I think they didn't get Amplify on him, and that was why they weren't able to burst him down. He did take a lot of damage, but not as fast as they would have liked. But so far, getting the Aegis successfully, I would say, chalked up as a big win for 1-3. So 20-12. Oh, they're gonna find Yamate. Oh, Mypro. Gonna walk right into Yamate. Yamate pops that ultimate and immediately back off. So the Lich already in the back lines there, ready to offer assistance if need be. And Lakel so far has not been having the most favorable game on Razor. Has been gotten punished over and over. But the plate mail now will try and alleviate some of that debuffing that'll be going on from 1-3. They've got quite a bit of debuffs here. They've got Medallion, Desolator, Amplify, and Weave being the big culprit. Can just set it up before the fight, and then of course amplifiers will just make it worse. But after a certain point, you don't take any more amplification. The math kind of works that way, but it does amplify to the point where you almost get one shot by a lot of things, so it doesn't really matter. And oh, going in, the gem will see the Observer Ward. We see you is right as Ice. Oh, well, not gonna go in there. Well, take your siege wagon's fun as well. Getting shards in once again. And looks like we will not be pushing the issue here. Ice taking a plasma field nuke. We'll see if Mypro joins the fight. He has deployed his illusions around the map, but oh, we're going in, we're balling in. Who are we rolling into? What? I don't know how that happened, but I'm waiting for that Doom initiation. They see Ben, they stun Ben up. There's the Doombringer. Where's my Doombringer? Doombringer so far farming the jungle there. And now Ben, he has the Aegis. He will be coming back in. They lost the Wyvern though. Now Ben will be taking down. Will he take down? Yes, he will. So he will not come back with Death Pack. He has Death Pack, but he doesn't have anyone. And they shook up a brew ready for him. And Mypro will stun himself. Oh no, Mypro, you screwed up bad. And now you're gonna pay. Ben gets in there, deploys his Desolator, and he will get Lakels now. So much bonus damage. And Ebba, unable to run away. Will he come in for a greedy blink? No, not gonna happen there. They will get a kill there. Yamate hunts down the Lich in the outskirts of that fight, and we'll take him out. Well, that's why you don't camp around that dead body. That Aegis playing a big part in that victory there. Although it was kind of my pro's fault for charging up the stun and not having the target to land on, and I guess that is why you got a BKB. I am sorry for doubting you, Klings. But it's now 24-13, and we are seeing a 14k net worth for 133. They are looking to take this game by the balls. What are you doing, man? That was very dangerous play. Yamateo will get tagged there by some cold embrace, and Abba will be slowed down as well. Ben, take a splinter blast, but it doesn't hurt him directly, so no harm, no foul. And Trust will throw out more ice shards, try and delay this push as fast as they could. And Jabs will throw out more shards, and this wave should be cleared out in time. So only down to that last tier 2 tower, Signature Trust, well, that minus armor strategy really coming into play here. And this Alchemist has been dying a tad bit much, giving a lot of net worth over to the enemy team. And this is why I think Alchemist is trash, you know. I think Alchemist is a bad hero. Overrated. Alright, bad hero is too much. Overrated. He's really not that great. He's really not that great. They're gonna kill some Bounty Hunter Illusions. They'll get an Observer Award as well. At least they didn't lose the gem. I think, which is a big plus, I think. Now they go for the smoke. And, see how they do, you know. That Bounty Hunter, wow, pulling the wave across. And was he watching it? I think he saw some Radiance burn. Yeah, I think he felt some Radiance burn on his illusion, and that's why they know they're smoked up. And this could earn very badly here. We see 133 posturing on that high ground there, looking for some targets. And that plate mail now on the Alchemist, so he could be looking for something big, but Ben getting caught out there. Where's that Dazzle? They go Winter's Curse on him. Will they get him out? The Chain Frost. Oh, Ben will survive. He pops that BKB. Will he survive though? The Radiant's Burn is going to be there, and the Radiant Burns will continue to burn him. That good crush from Yamate will stop him out. Now Mypro getting doomed out. Pentagram. But that's going to be spent. He's going to out regen this one. He's going to survive, I'm pretty sure. Bounty has it going in for sure. It can toss. That's very greedy. Abba goes in there, punches him in the nose. Splinter Blast will slow him down, but Abba is now very, very, very hurt. Oh, what are you doing? My friend gets punished. Cold Embrace not even able to be there. And I'm not sure what Tusker was doing there. Abba falling asleep at his keyboard there and getting punished. Well, Alchemist going to get cleave there. 3-4-3. Coming in now and getting that kill. Yamate still hunting for blood. This is the aggressive player that we know him to be. And he is being extremely aggressive here. Fame out. Fat cat, you are in trouble, my friend. Cold Embrace will secure that. Yamate will get punished. No, he will not. He'll pop that BKB. Still punished, I would say, as you use that BKB charge for a very minor stun. And now Mypro TPing up top to continue the rat adventures as he deploys his illusions to deal with middle. And Mypro now gonna heal up 2600 gold now on this guy. What will he buy here? Assault Cuirass seems to be the natural choice. Think about any Aghanims that could be picked up here. Lich could have one, and Tuska, I would say Warrior's Kick. Warrior's Kick is cute. Alright, we'll see if Warrior's Kick does play a part here. I don't know. I don't know how Warrior's Kick works now, but does it do something? Alright, let me just lower my audio threshold in the game. I think some of you guys were complaining. Alright. Gotta lower my audio threshold for the in-game mic. Just some guy just gave me some feedback, so just a little quick tweak here. And there, Dota TV guys, you should be able to hear it in 2 minutes. I apologize for not checking it earlier. But we had a little bit of a lull, you know, we had kind of bit too many kills in this game to keep track of. And we've got a 20,000 gold XP lead and a gold lead of 15k here for 133. Now, they're really enjoying this lead. Alchemist to the top, but that's all there is. He's right at the top and none of his teammates are there. All of them are just sitting in the mid range. Well, one in the mid range and the rest are in the bottom. And he really needs to help pump them up. Mypro is going to pick up that Hyperstone, so got to finish that full Assault Cuirass now. And we'll see what else he does decide to go for. He has that one more item of choice. Will it be a Mjolnir? I'm not sure, but I think an Aghanim's boost could work here for Lich. And Aghanim's boost could work for Tuskar, kicking a target away from the fight. We'll see how useful that is. I mean, how far does it kick though? 900? But yeah. Right, so far, Lakels. It is still a best of three. For you guys who's tuning in, this is Summit C, Summit 4C qualifiers. And right now, we're having Signature Trust versus 133, and we're going to have a huge wraparound here using the back entrance. 1-2-3. Well, they're going to, well, help Trust feel the pain. Do we have Ultimate here from my pro, yes we do. So he has that ultimate ready. Will he deploy it is the question. Oh, Ban gonna get caught out, and now Lakel's gonna get doomed right off the bat. There'll be no running away from this. They'll cold embrace him. They'll build him out a little bit. He'll tick down a little bit, but now Fame out running away. What a crush there! Yamatek gets the first hit bash. No, he will not. He will not. They will only get that Razor kill and a good bailout here. They'll just continue pushing the wave. MyPro not even using his ultimate for this. Getting that Manta style illusion split. And just running away from everything. This Manta illusion, 22 second cooldown, easy peasy. Lasting for 20 seconds, 22 second cooldown. So it's almost like permanent illusions. And it will just keep burning and burning away at your life. Now gonna deploy that instant Manta split. Goes back into the waves. And yeah, you'll always have these waves pushed out. And Alchemist will keep printing that money. So, annoying. Meanwhile, Yamate, once again, gonna be stealing from the Dire Ancients, but hey, you can't blame him. He needs to keep up with the economy here, as Alchemist is still top heavy. 26,000 Doom with his own personal mint as well. The Midas will be able to get about just as much. Oh no, they found Abba. They found Abba. Abba goes for the Snowball. Will he get out away in time? Good Chain Frost? No. And interesting, Chain Frost will actually just bounce between the targets there. And, well, a couple of nukes, you know, not too much to worry about. With Fame out, not having the Aghanims there. So he's just gonna be waiting patiently for his buddy Alchemist to give it to him. Ban, oh, he sees this Alchemist.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
How will they kill him though? I don't think they kill him, even. Okay, Ban, really, Ban? What is he hoping to achieve there? I don't know. He could have died. He really could have died.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Alright. So, nothing much to worry about for now. The Alchemist, going back to farming. Picks up an Abyssal Blade. I can get behind this. Yeah, he needs lockdown. Roshan goes down for the third time this fight. It will be cheese for Doomy. Or drops the Blick Dagger. No, drop your scroll, dude. Yes. Alright, drops the scroll. Nearly did something silly. But yeah, not gonna be too much of a trouble there. Alchemist will think about TPing to the top lane and realizing that it might be a tad dangerous without buyback, so we'll actually get that bounty rune first.
We'll
300
that.
Away from buyback, we'll take that for sure. And we'll have that mana cell ready in just a bit there. So the Chemical Rage is gonna wear off now, but his illusions will maintain. And oh, look at that. The Alchemist illusion's just gonna run down to the top, run down to the middle, and well, we're gonna have ourselves a good time. Oh yeah, Razor Aghanims, I just forgot about that too. You know, I just assume Razor didn't have an Aghanims, and I think, yeah, that's what he really needs. He needs an Aghanims. But yeah, I think Razor at this point is just pretty much dead. I'd like to see some Lotus Orbs, you know. Lotus Orbs in this game would be really good at dispelling track, amplify damage. It has good uses outside of tagging, well, deflecting Doom or deflecting anything. You can deflect a lot of good stuff here. You can deflect Poison Touch is lame, yeah, but you can deflect amplified damage. I think that's huge. Amplified Doom, of course. Deflect Dooming would be big. You know, deflecting even track would be pretty cool. Shuriken Toss, all that good stuff. You know, I think it's a really good bonus that you could really look to invest into. But looks like none of these players are getting it for now. They're just grabbing up Blink Daggers. I'd like to see Lotus Orb used more. I think maybe a lot of people forget that he has a dispelling element to it as well, and it even removes Hex. That's how good Lotus Orb is, you know. So, I'd see more usage coming up from players. But, well, for now, we're just gonna have MyPro running in there, cosplaying as Naga. Gets heal bombed right out of existence, but we have a second one here, no problemo. We'll chop down his creep wave, but he only has 0 seconds of life left, so he'll just burn away into crisp. Meanwhile, Manta, re-illusions, going in. And the constant rat will begin, you know, this slow tickle. And you can see this plateauing out. As the death stop coming in, they'll start tracking down once again. So that track gold has played a big part in this game, but it's starting to taper off. As you don't get kills, you don't get money. And this Alchemist will continue printing money, give 4,000 net worth to Razor, give 4,000 net worth to Lich, Tuska, all those good things. And but for now, he's just going to be farming this Abyssal Blade. He's got 3,000 gold already. And Bounty Hunter stashing one of those gems in his eye, and another one in the stash. You know, for future use, I like this Aghanim Scepter pickup from Dazzle. It will reduce even more armor faster as well. Not only does it reduce more, it reduces it faster. More Bounty Rune, 600 bucks. It's like taking out two towers. Rich. Richer McRicherson. Then we have Jabs. It's going to be tagging along with him. They're waiting out this Aegis timing, and I like this a lot. This tier 2 tower probably not going to be long for the world, as we have a double damage here on Ben. It's going to melt this tower. He has Rapier's amount of damage. And here we go. Pew, pew. Whoa, goodbye tower. And even solo cresting this creep to make it extra tanky. And we'll have that creep wave run in there. The frost armor will secure some protection to this tier 3, but the tier 3 already going down there. That Kling's damage is too high. The plasma fuel comes out, tags Kling's on the tail end of it. But Ice ready to blink in at a moment's notice. Has refresher as well, able to pretty much delete two heroes from this fight, so they'll have to really choose their fights carefully. And this Alchemist going down in two shots there. The MKB from Ben gonna be more than enough. Now here comes the crush from Yabate, but he screws up big. But Mypro, he could be doomed up here. Ice waiting, but Acid Spray cancels up his Blink Dagger. He says, alright guys, I'm gonna disable here. I'm not gonna be able to deploy the bombs, as they would say. So they're not gonna try anything here, but they're gonna try some funky stuff as the enemy goes on the retreat here. Ben gonna get caught under a sentry ward. This could be huge, but there is a... okay, nope, he turns it around. Good call and brace. They will take him out once, but they take him out a second time. The Doombringer has actually TP'd down to the top lane, so this has been a throw. The Abyssal Blade comes in, he gets bashed to hell. And there we go, Ben gonna take a fall here. Mega kill going to Razor, and they even find a second one here. Minerva, the Dazzle, the Priest, unable to save himself as the Plasma Field comes in and comboed up with the punches. Will actually secure two quick kills here for that Thailand squad. 2,500 gold going over right off the bat. We got 1,000 gold lost here as well. So 1-3-3 will fight without their Aegis, fight without their Klings for a long period of time. I really, really would strongly suggest that Trust picked up at least one Lotus Orb for the Hex later on, because that is going to be so, so important. So right now, Signature Trust, they have that 44-minute timing window. With your Alchemist fully slotted up, he has the money to start building Anakin's for his team now. So please start building Anakin's for your team. I think they're going to try to bait this Kling's buyback. He does have buyback on this. Yeah, they're going to bait it out and then try and get something done. Lakel's pushing in like that, almost baiting the Doom at this point. But we'll see how it is going to be. The Acid Spray is going to be pretty huge. We have Yamate sitting the back lines there. Is he tagged up? He's spotted out. They have 18 seconds left on Kling's. Are they going to try and bail him out? The Radiant's burn so far is keeping them away from the front of the fight. And it looks like it is time to back off as it is 10 seconds to the return of Kling. So they're going in there and TP up to the top lane. And yeah, there we go. Crush. Nope. He's going to level death it up. And yep, Alchemist fully stacked, so we should be seeing some Santa Claus going on here. Let the sweatshop commence, as he will start shopping for his items and get that money for his team. So right now at 3,500 gold, it should be a Lich Aghanim's first. I would say Lich Aghanim's first. Razor is pretty rich, he could be getting something else there, but should be Lich Aghanim's first. And well, actually, should you give a Lich Aghanim's first? Probably not. The fights aren't as clumped up as you'd like them to be for 1-2-3. So maybe, yeah, maybe a raise out. Aghanim can do more good when he's doomed, because that's what he's going to be doing anyway, getting doomed. So, we'll see. Mypro, 20 seconds left on that Boots of Travel. Will he be able to do more damage? Here's the question now. Pops into that Mantis Cell once again. They'll start pushing out the wave. The smoked up crew, or rather not smoked up, just camping crew here. Of Sick Trust, they're gonna spot out this Alchemist Illusion and even gets that guy on the tail end. So he sends it up top. So sends one middle, sends one top, and this one's gonna puff out in time. Yeah, it's gonna puff out, and he's gonna have another Manta ready, and it's gonna be closer to Creep Wave this time. Gonna push them away even further, and now he has a full Ag's worth of money, but still has to save for the buyback for now. So for now, just gonna be chilling, farming up the Radiant Jungle, and I like this. They're just pushing the waves away. Look at this. They're unable to do much to this. He's gonna send them back in and says, alright, time to farm more. All that money, all that moolah going in. The Shiva's got having to clean up on Owl3 as Mypro goes down there to mess up Owl4. And, well, Ben, how's he looking here? He's got that Void Stone. He's got a Monkey King bar and about 3,000 gold. His buyback wasn't forced in the last fight, which is a huge bonus here from 1-3-3, so they're going to be able to have that buyback ready. They might have the option of going for a Hex in an all-in play, try and take it out, pull the rug from under Sick Trust as quick as possible. But yeah, Mypro, 6,005, it's time to give your friend some money, my friend. You have 4,300 surplus. It's time to do it. Don't let those dreams be dreams. Look at Lich. He's begging you for it. Let him get a Lotus Orb. Get that Aghanim Scepter for your friend, man. Well, Yamate picks up a Salt Q-Ross. BKB as well. A lot of physical burst. And yes! Yes! Lotus Orb! It better not be a Lincoln's. I'll be so mad. Lincoln's is not going to be effective. Let me give you a few examples. Wait, what's going on? Okay, no. Alright, yeah, so 4 staffs, amplify damages, level death. I mean, I just assume that it isn't level death causing the trouble. 4 staffs, poison touch, all these things are going to cause so much. Yeah! Lich! Lich, my man, getting that ulti Chain Frost. Time to go stack the Ancients with your Chain Frost. Oh no, these dragons just feed, so nope. Need more Ancients for that. And such, you know, play a little bit of techies, do a little bit of that. But yeah, the sweatshop has commenced, and he's gonna start giving Aghanims to his teammates. And this is huge, you know. He's gonna have that net worth suddenly boosted up. Does it give him the net worth? I'm not sure. I think it does. It boosts his net worth. I didn't check. I think it does. And look at that. 200 health, 150 mana, 10 to all attributes. Look at this. It's a happy Lich. My pro says, "You're welcome. Be naughty next year, and you will not get one." Roshan respawns an 8. That's actually pretty big. They forget to smoke with their Alchemist, but it's okay. He just escaped a particularly nasty gank. We're going in. Alchemist just seemingly free farming around the map there. We get our courier tagging him up. And well, you look at that. Alchemist running in with his illusion. Gonna clear up this creep wave. And yeah, middle lane is where it's at. They're gonna crush that Mypro one. And they have to clear him out. They'll drag the creep wave back, soften this wave up, and it looks like my pro will be required there. You'll have to split first. Alright, so he's not going to continue this push. It's kind of a shame. I think he needed to split there. But yeah, he's going to split here instead. It's more safe for him. And they know that courier. That courier, they're waiting up top. They're waiting. They see it. I think they see him, right? Do they see this? Yeah, they see this. They see this. They see this. Daz Courier goes down. So Minerva, they see him from the top lane. They're coming in. And now Minerva pops in. Gets caught first thing out. But they already took the Aegis of Klinks. Already getting caught by the Doom coming out. Look out. He's going to get frozen up. The Chain Frost is going to perma bounce. This is going to be big. No, it's not. It's not. It bounces to Klinks and just fizzles out like a snowball. It's going down. But Doom, he's getting caught there with 1 health. He's trying to run away, but he's not running. Not from Alchemist. Never mind. She's just kidding. We'll thrust it out on him. No! Getting doomed. Seriously, my pro, why the greed, my friend? Why the greed? Getting caught out now gets the counter doom on him, my pro. He does have buyback. He's trying to outbash Ben, but not gonna be getting that. He will get 3 kills there on the enemy, and now Jab's gonna get punished as well. Cheese up. Nope, not gonna waste that cheese. And well, they have an opening now. Are we gonna get a buyback? Lich even falling there to the bounty hunter from out far. Alchemy is the future. Well, we'll see if that is the case. He does have his ultimate. He pops that manta. He's gonna try and spin that out. Everyone buys back into the game. Lich doesn't have money, so. So Alchemist is gonna come back in there, but this is a huge loss there. That Roshan went down faster than they expected. And as a result, they will not be able to get any kind of contest. With the Wyvern was close, you know, nearly get that curse off, nearly get that. Then they got that Aegis steal, but no, it wasn't big enough, and having mass bought out here, they will be punished pretty heavily in their next death. So they look to be on their twilight years now, as we call it. That Golgroth doing a little wave, a whip back up there. Going down to 10k, nope, 16k. Still 1-3-3 favorite, and that XP Groth really just surging through the roof there, reaching that obscene level. Bounty Hunter gets a Lotus Orb of his own, okay. Deflecting an Aghanim's Chain Frost could be huge. Punches up the Doom into this guy, Shiva's Guard as well. They sap him up. Splinter Blast. Are we going to be able to kill him though? 4 star from Bounty Hunter. Trying to save his life, but the stun will come out. I will throw out that stun backwards. But is it going to be enough though? Is it going to be enough? That Doom running pretty fast. They will commit that curse over to that kill. And they will punch him up a second time. And that's a tough Doom to kill. They pick him off, but he still has 4,000 gold in the bank. Easy buyback for him. He has Doom ready. And I'm not sure, man. It's not gonna be easy. And can you drop Octarine Core? I'm not sure. Let's grab it passively for that miner's armor. Now we go Slaughter coming in, and Doombai is back immediately. The Klaus gonna get caught out by the Bai. Oh, the TP coming in from Doom immediately comes in. Oh, good battle style. Are we confused? Yes, we are. We are confused. Running away in the snow. Coming in, Ice. Will they be able to kill him off in time? The Chain Frost going in there. They actually doom him off in time. But now the Chain Frost, they're bouncing. No, stick away from each other, guys. All right, sharing is not caring sometimes. But they lose Razor and they lose Tuska again. No buybacks for these guys for the next 5 minutes. My Pro will heal this. But this might have just cost them the game. They're going to be defending this without buybacks. Yeah, not the best way to play this game. I'm not sure why he was doing so much surplus in his bank though. Should have bought up those items right off the bat. They'll at least be losing some Raxes here if I'm not wrong. And if I'm not wrong, they should be losing their throne as well. 50 seconds should be ample amount of time to lose a couple of set of Raxes there. And oh man, Slot punishing a bad Lich positioning there. Not even getting a chance to go Scepter up, and Ben already with that Lotus Orb is going to do some serious work. And well, even getting the crush there, that Lotus Orb could be enough there. The Splinter Blast. Oh, we're going to tag some heroes there. Well, the track will come out. It looks like they're going to be looking at that Splinter Blast onto Ben. Ben losing quite a fair bit of life, but he'll get that tower. And the Rex should coming in as well. The stuns are coming in. Oh, Jeff, two hits. Easy peasy. Oh boy, that's one side of Rex down. 70 seconds on the sidelines there for that Winter Wyvern. So like I said, at least two sides of Rex before they can try and take some fight there. But there's a Refresher Doom and even a Double Doom coming in soon. So I'm not so sure what their chances are for a hold. And like I said, Alchemist, dumpster here. Dumpster, dumpster. Look at our net worth. All that net worth for nothing. Easily kited, really weak in damage output, relies too much on items, and we're gonna toss out a stun. Yeah, we are gonna punch him up. We're gonna chain stun him up. Yamate could be chain stun down. Chain Frost, good stuff. We'll get that kill, but hey, look at that. Chain Frost is perma, but it's not gonna be the best. It's gonna bounce back to this huge green wave. Good stuff. It's gonna keep that Chain Frost alive. They will actually doom up Razor. My Ben getting bashed on the first hit, punched into the air. He loses his life. And oh no, the Chain Frost still going on here. Perma Frost there, like you said. And now the ball's coming in. The ball coming in, looking for 343. Not gonna find him. They're still looking for the Shiva's gun. He has that Refresher Doom. 60 seconds on that silence. Does he want to use it though? It's another question. They refresh it up. They will doom him up, but I'm not sure. He pops that stun right as he gets hit. He's just gonna so suicide in there. And he actually gets a stun on Doom. Yamate very low, but my pro even lower. He goes down. No buyback. No buyback for 2 minutes. Monster kill for Yamate. Slaughter buys back into the game. He knows that this is it. If he gets this kill, it's game over, man. Octarine. He does have that Octarine, so that's really fast. But Lakels, what are you doing, my friend? Okay, the purge comes in. Shiva's got good stuff. We'll tag out that. We'll tag out on that kill. So now they're gonna shoot their own Doombringer. Nope. Staying out of the curse range, Yamate comes in. It will be immune, but really nothing much you can do here. And Yamate getting a double kill with that buyback. And with so many heroes on the sidelines, I guess this is their last leg. Signature Trust will be falling under for this game one of this BO3. And I guess wrong. 1-2-3 do come back. They shape up over the side of over the course of a week, man. The Nanyang Championship performance was abysmal, and this is a full 180. I'm really impressed by this play here from Yamate and Chris Crew. It looks like they're gonna take this summit qualifier seriously. And Trust, well, they have a fight on their hands. I would expect the Kelsen team to do a lot better than this, but they fall short. Like I said, that Doombringer, very pivotal. I think Doom is back in this version, guys. I might be a little late to the party, but Doom is back, my friends. Doom is back.